Welcome to our web service for the 19th Sunday in the season of hope, or as the Church of England calls it, the 8th Sunday after Trinity. The 2nd of August will be our first public service of worship, and we will be celebrating morning prayer. The following week on the 9th will be evening prayer, and we will alternate each Sunday service. All current government and church guidelines must be adhered to, and all who attend must wear face masks. Thank you. Welcome to this place of worship, house of prayer for many, home to all who come. Welcome to this gathering place, friend and stranger, saint and sinner, and all who gather here. Come with hope or hesitation. Come with joy or yearning. All who hunger, all who thirst for life in all its fullness. Generous God and generous Saviour, touch us through your Spirit. We say together our prayer of preparation. Christ, come to be with us, be our home and our belonging place, the hearth fire we come back to, and the bond that binds us all. Be the one who holds us all together, be the reason for our sharing and the rhythm of our work song, be the heart of our joined lives. Amen. We say our prayers for saying sorry. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, the first commandment is this: Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is the only Lord. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second is this: Love your neighbor as yourself. There is no other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Together in worship, we face what we might not face alone. We are sometimes lazy and fail to love God. Lord, forgive us and heal us. We are sometimes selfish, but fail to love ourselves. Lord, forgive us and heal us. We are human, but sometimes fail to love others. Lord, forgive us and heal us. We share now in silence as we remember our own faults and failings. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We now stand together to say the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill to all people. We praise you, we bless you, we worship you. Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, who takes away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. You who take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You who sit at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you only are holy, only you are Lord, Jesus Christ, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Our collect for today. Lord God, your Son left the riches of heaven and became poor for our sake. When we prosper, save us from pride. When we are needy, save us from despair, that we may trust in you alone, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Our first reading is from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 55, and reading from verse 1. Everyone who thirsts, come to the waters, and you that have no money, come, buy and eat. Come, buy wine and milk without money and without price. Why do you spend your money for that which is not bread, and your labour for that which does not satisfy? Listen carefully to me and eat what is good, and delight yourselves in rich food. Incline your ear and come to me. Listen so that you may live. I will make with you an everlasting covenant, my steadfast, sure love for David. See, I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and commander for the peoples. See, you shall call nations that you do not know, and nations that do not know you shall run to you because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
I am not sure why he would. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Now when Jesus heard this, he withdrew from there in a boat to a deserted place by himself. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them and cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a deserted place, and the hour is now late. Send the crowds away so that they may go into the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, "They need not go away. You give them something to eat." They replied, "We have nothing here but 5 loaves and 2 fish." And he said, "Bring them here to me." Then he ordered the crowds to sit on the grass. Taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven and blessed and broke the loaves and gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the crowds. And all ate and were filled, and they took up what was left over of the broken pieces, 12 baskets full. And those who ate were 5,000 men, besides women and children. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Our gospel passage opens with these words. Now when Jesus heard this, he withdrew from there in a boat to a deserted place by himself. When Jesus heard about what, you might ask? Well, Jesus had just been informed of the execution of his cousin John, beheaded on King Herod's orders. Jesus must have been devastated. Jesus and John were of the same age. Their mothers stayed together when they were both pregnant. Jesus and John probably played together as boys at family gatherings. Jesus was baptized by John to begin his ministry. The death of John must have been felt very deeply by Jesus. He needed time. He needed time to be alone. He needed time to pray. He needed time to gather himself, time to grieve, even time to cry. So Jesus got in a boat and headed out across the water to a deserted and lonely place, at least. That's what he thought. But for Jesus, there was no getting away. There was no opportunity for grief, no time to be alone, no time to pray. The people went around the lake to meet him. When Jesus left the boat, they were already there, thousands of them. What should Jesus have done? It would have been realistic for his disciples to say to the crowd, "He's not available. He's just had a shocking bereavement. He needs time to grieve. He needs time to pray. He needs time to mourn. He will come and see you later. He will come back." When Jesus went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them. He cured their sick. No matter how great his own need for space and time to grieve, Jesus felt that their need was greater. Maybe Jesus saw in them the same sadness, the same loneliness, the same yearning for healing that he must have felt deep within his own soul at the loss of John. The word compassion means to suffer with another person. So Jesus sat down with the crowd and basically held a service of healing. He cured the sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a deserted place and it's now late." They had obviously been there a long time. And they said to Jesus, "Send the crowds away so that they may go into the villages and buy food for them." Jesus said to his disciples, "They needn't go away. You give them something to eat." The disciples replied, "We have nothing here but 5 loaves and 2 fish."
Now, could it have been that the disciples were saying, all we've got is what we brought for our own supper? We do care about these people and their hunger, but we have to take care of ourselves first, right? Jesus' response was this, bring the loaves and the fish to me. Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Taking the loaves and the fish, he looked up to heaven and blessed them. He gave them to his disciples, who shared them among the crowd. Now, in the middle of the world's trials and tribulations, in the middle of the world's pains and sorrows, its disappointments and its despairs, we hear these words about Jesus. He had compassion. They reveal to us the heart and soul of the gospel, the assurance that God knows and that God cares. Jesus' response to John's death and the crowd's need is a gentle whisper across the centuries that God is a very present help in time of trouble. One of the important lessons from the gospel story is that it calls us to raise our eyes above our own needs, and raise our eyes above the limits of our own resources. It causes us to realize that our thinking is often just too small. Our thinking is often too self-centered. So this passage encourages us, even urges us, to look at the needs of the world around us, to share with them, all of them, the compassion of the God who loves us, who loves all of us. A God that will take even the very little that we might offer reluctantly and turn it into enough and more than enough. We are called to be a community of compassion, people who show the world that God is alive and God is love. In the kingdom of God, there is enough for everyone when it is distributed fairly, without hoarding, without exploitation. Then there is enough. No one goes hungry. When they offer to God even the little that they had, our God is able to do immeasurably more than all we can ask or all that we can even imagine. So let us be a community of compassion. Let us be people who show the world that God is alive and God is love by our compassion. Amen.
We say together our words of faith. We believe in God above us, maker and sustainer of all life, of sun and moon, of water and earth, of male and female. We believe in God beside us, Jesus Christ, the Word made flesh, born of a woman, servant of the poor, tortured and nailed to a tree. He died forsaken. He descended into the earth, to the place of death. On the third day he rose from the tomb. He ascended into heaven to be everywhere present, and his kingdom will come on earth. We believe in God within us, the Holy Spirit of Pentecostal fire, life-giving breath of the church, Spirit of healing and forgiveness, source of resurrection and eternal life. Amen.
Let us pray. If someone who possesses the good things of this world sees someone in need and withholds compassion from him, how can it be said that the love of God dwells in him? God of love, you see all the suffering, injustice and misery in this world. Have pity, we pray, on what you have created. In your mercy, look upon the poor, the oppressed, and the destitute. Fill our hearts with deep compassion for those who suffer, and hasten the coming of your kingdom of justice and truth. For the sake of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Heavenly Father, the compassion you have for your creation transcends all boundaries of race, creed, and culture. You, Lord, did not judge anyone before you helped them. And we pray that you would open our eyes and ears to see others the way you see them, and share your divine love with them, that they might know the hope of the kingdom of God in their hearts and your healing in their lives. God of compassion, hear us and help us. Merciful and compassionate Lord, the world we live in has been turned upside down by COVID-19, and our thoughts turn to those who are facing redundancy and unemployment. As a result of the financial crisis caused by the lockdown in this country and in the world in general, we acknowledge that the society we live in post-lockdown will not be the same as we were used to, and we pray for those, especially in Tamworth and Hopewash, who will have to make adjustments to how they live and how they work. We pray for the government to have compassion on all in need of their help in regards to benefits and help finding work or retraining. May our politicians be guided by you to bring about the best outcome to meet the situations of those in need. God of compassion, hear us and help us. We come before you, Lord, and give thanks for your grace and mercy in our lives. We praise you because you are the God of compassion, and you sent your Son to show us what compassion really means. Jesus, as we read in the Gospel today, although you were grieving for your cousin John, you could not ignore the crowds of people who had followed you to the place you had sought for time to yourself. Forgive us, Lord, when we don't put the needs of others before ourselves. The situation of the lockdown has shown us that there is always a need for us to look after each other and to encourage each other to stand firm in the faith that God has given us. We pray that moving forward, we will always be mindful of the needs of our fellow brothers and sisters in Christ and the wider community in which we live, that by our acts of compassion and kindness, your glory would be revealed in this world. God of compassion, hear us and help us. Father, the coronavirus is never far from our thoughts, and so too are those who are suffering in its wake. We continue to pray for those affected by it in any way, especially those who are now extremely fearful of going out at all, where there are other people in close proximity, even socially distancing. And we continue to pray for those we know who are sick and whose lives are very limited to what they can do at this present time. We continue to pray for Beryl and Roger, Audrey, Catherine and Derek, Jim, Barbara Bott, Jack, Margaret Dale, Leslie Fox, Dave Atkinson. And we take a moment to remember those known to us personally. Compassionate Lord, may your strength and comfort provide the courage and the trust that leads us to the love and peace of the Father's heart. God of compassion, hear us and help us. Hear us, good Lord, as we pray for those families who have lost loved ones, either directly or indirectly to COVID-19. Be with those who grieve and also with those who are supporting them, that they may know your love in these difficult times. God of compassion, hear us and help us. Lord Jesus, in a world that needs compassion more than ever before, may we follow your example and open our eyes, our ears, and our hearts to those around us, as your Holy Spirit fills us with the compassionate love of God. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Blessed are the peacemakers. They shall be called children of God. We meet in the name of Christ and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you, and also with you. Yours, Lord, is the greatness, the power, the glory, the splendor, and the majesty. For everything in heaven and on earth is yours. All things come from you, and of your own do we give you. The Lord be with you, and also with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give thanks and praise. Blessed are you, Lord God, our light and our salvation. To you be glory and praise forever. From the beginning, you have created all things, and all your works echo the silent music of your praise. In the fullness of time, you made us in your image, the crown of all creation. You gave us breath and speech, that with the angels and the archangels and all the powers of heaven, we may find a voice to sing your praise, saying together, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. How wonderful the works of your hands, O Lord. As a mother tenderly gathers her children, you embrace the people as your own. When they turned away and rebelled, your love remained steadfast. From them you raised up Jesus, our Saviour, born of Mary, to be the living bread, in whom all our hungers are satisfied. He offered his life for sinners, and with a love stronger than death, he opened wide his arms upon the cross. On the night before he died, he came to supper with his friends, and taking bread, he gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." At the end of supper, taking the cup of wine, he gave you thanks and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. Father, we plead with confidence, his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross, and remember his dying and rising in glory. And we rejoice that he intercedes for us at your right hand. Pour out your Holy Spirit as we bring before you these gifts of your creation. May they be for us the body and the blood of your dear Son. As we eat and drink these holy things in your presence, form us in the likeness of Christ and build us into a living temple to your glory. Bring us with Chad and all the saints to the vision of that eternal splendor for which you have created us. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom, with whom, and in whom, with all who stand before you, in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise. Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen. And so we share together in the words that Jesus himself has taught us, beginning, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen." We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. We say together, "Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us." Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world, grant us peace. Share together in this meal, where loss finds comfort in promise and despair is transformed into hope. Whoever you are, whatever you bring, hear the risen Christ call your name and accept God's invitation to new life. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word and I shall be healed. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ keep you in eternal life. Amen. The blood of Christ, the cup of salvation. Amen. We say together now our prayer after communion. Almighty God, we thank you for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him we offer you our souls and bodies to be a living sacrifice. Send us out in the power of your Spirit to live and work to your praise and glory. Amen. We now sing our final hymn. May the everlasting God shield you, east and west, and wherever you go. And the blessing of God be upon you, the blessing of the God of life. The blessing of Christ be upon you, the blessing of the Christ of love. The blessing of the Spirit be upon you, the blessing of the Spirit of grace. May the blessing of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit be with you and all those whom you love, now and forevermore. Let us go into the world rejoicing. It is Christ who goes before us. Thanks be to God. Amen.